नमस्ते, इज स्क्रीन विजिबल?
यस
पिंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटि सौत्रो निर्विघ्नं कुरु शुभकार सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंतां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृत वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्री चित्रगणेशाय नमो। बीजं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपयो अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धिर्दृक्यत्र निर्मलं अपारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्यक्षं महः तदेवाहं नमस्तोऽन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। ब्रह्माण व्याति पूर्वं वेदांश्च प्रणोत्यस्मि तगुंह देवमात्मबुद्धि प्रकाश मोक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। Continuing in the fourth chapter, व्यवहारकाले ज्ञानी अपि आत्मविमुख एव सः विषयानन्दस्य स्वरूपानन्दात् अभिन्नतां मन्यते। So the only difference between a jnani and ajnani in vyavahara is that the jnani knows that the vishyananda pratiti is due to Atmananda. Vishyananda itself is manifestation of Atmananda, nothing else. There is no Ananda in Vishaya per se, it is a Brahma. He knows that, whereas an Ajnani does not know that, and thereby he hankers after Vishyananda. So, you're looking at the Vishaya Pravritti Kale Ajnyavad Aste Jnani Api. Because it is said, Tattva Vismarana Purvakam Meva Pravartate. Jnani also. Jnani cha yada vyavahare pravartate, tada saha Tattva Vismarana Purvakam Meva Pravartate. And the Tippanakara had said, he had quoted, that's why Bhagavan Bhashyakara says in Adhyasa Bhasha, Bhashya, Pashwadi Vishcha Visheshat, meaning Pashwadi Vish Samanaha Ityartha. In Vyavahara, human beings are similar to Pashus because we also want Ananda like them, or rather they also, there is nothing different between their pursuit of Sukha and our pursuit of Sukha, their avoidance of Dukkha and our avoidance of Dukkha. Thereby, Jnani, the question of Tattva Drishti, whether Jnani also has this pravritti towards Vishaya, and he also has Vishyananda. Yes, he has Vishyananda, but he knows that Vishyananda is not different from Atmananda. Vishay Pravritti Kale Ajnyavad Aste Jnani Api. Jnani remains like Ajnya. That is why it is difficult to know who is a Jnani, who is not a Jnani. Only a Jnani can know. He himself can know. One knows. One may fool the world, but one will know within whether one is a jnani or an ajnani. Jnaninah chittam sada eva atmakaram eva yadi syat. If the argument given is no, jnani has atmakara vritti all the time. If that were really so, then there would be no pravritti at all. There is no interaction possible, says the sadhu here. Jnanino hi chittam सदैव आत्माकारम् एव यदि स्यात् तदा तस्य जीवनादि निमित्त भोजनादि व्यवहारोऽपि न सिद्ध्येत्। He won't even be able to have food because आत्माकार वृत्ति means there is no outward interaction at all. There won't be a possibility of even having food. But you see, Jnani is picking up food by himself and feeding himself. We are not talking about Samadhi Avastha, where, you know, somebody is in Samadhi and to keep the body alive, you know, there is force feeding. There have been cases where force feeding has been done to keep the body alive, because body becomes kind of numb when the person goes into Nirvikalpaka Samadhi, and it is said that the body may fall off. A particular time is given, 21 days, etc. But nonetheless, we are not talking about force feeding, we are talking about a jnani. Regardless of the samadhi, anubhava, the jnani who has this aikya jnana, has nishtha in the tattva, without any samshaya, he has landed on the tattva and he is completely committed to that jnana. Does he interact at all? We see in the sampradaya, we see there is teaching going on. It is not by an ajnani, it is by a jnani. Then how is that interaction also possible? When bhojana itself will not be possible, then how these, you know, saints like Bhagavad Padacharya, etc., how have they taught? Not by being ajnanis, definitely by being jnanis. But then during the interaction, it is brought back. The world is brought back. The duality is given a notional value. And then the teaching sampradaya or anything, any vyavahara. Jnanino hi chittam sada eva atmakaram eva yadi syat. Tada tasya jivanadi nimitta bhojanadi vyavahara upina siddhye tasmad atmayumuka buddhir ubhayo samaha. Sorry, buddhi sama. The buddhi is sama ubhayoho for both. Atmayumuka buddhi. The buddhi which is not focused inward but outward is common. But there also, what is the difference? The outward world is not different from the inward atma. For a jnani, for an ajnani, it is different. Ajnasya buddhi sada vishyasaktatvad atmimukha eva tishtati. In the case of an ajnani, his buddhi remains focused outward, paranchikhani, all his indriyas are tuned outward all the time, sada sarvada. Why vishyasaktatvad? Because his asakti is in the vishaya. Whereas jnani is indulging not for his own sake. He is interacting with the world for sharirasthiti or for lokasangraha ityadi. Jnaninastu buddhi yada atmano vimukha bhavati. When it is moving out, the buddhi, for a jnani, in the case of a jnani, tada vishechha tatsamparkad atmasurupananda vivyaktischa ajnasya iva tasyapi jayate. So the vishaya ichcha, ichcha has to be there, because there, it may not be a tamasika ichcha. It may, there has to be some ichcha backing that I want to interact with the world. Even if it is for the sake of lokasangraha, he wants to teach the shishya, he wants to do good to the society, he wants to, for the dharma to continue. All this is ichcha. So that ichcha should be there, be it at any subtle level, may it not be binding, may it be sattvika ichcha, but still that ichcha should be there. Otherwise, karma will not be possible. Tada visheichcha tatsamparkad atmasvarupananda abhivyaktischa. The atmasvarupa, the vishaya and vishaya samparkad, due to connection with the vishaya, what happens? This atmasvarupananda, one's own svarupananda, which the jnani knows, abhivyaktischa, its atma swarupananda abhivyaktischa ajnasya iva tasya api jayate. The manifestation of atmananda is same in the case of both, but the ajnani does not know it is atmananda, whereas the jnani knows it is atmananda itself, appearing as vishyananda. Tatha api asti atra vishesha. Although there is commonality shown, what is the vishesha difference between the two? Vishesha samparkad bhasamanaha api anandaha swarupanandat na tirichyate. Even if the pratiti is that anandotpatti is due to the vishesha samparka, still that ananda is not different from swarupananda. Swarupanandat na tirichyate. Kintu tadabhasa eva iti vijanati brahmavit. that it appears to be different, generated due to Vishaya, is the thinking of the Jnani, whereas Ajnani does not know. Tathacha, Vishaya Bhogyapi Jnani na Samadhi Reva Siddhyati. Therefore, it has said, you know, Yatra Yatra Mano Yati, Tatra Tatra Samadhyaha. For a Jnani, wherever the mind goes, everything is what? Atma Swarupa. Sarvam Kalvidam Brahma. There is nothing other than that Brahma Tattva, which is his own Swarupa. Therefore, wherever the mind goes, there is Samadhi. Samadhi need not be, you know, sitting in a cave. This is what is called as Sahaja Samadhi. Not a technical word in the Yoga Shastra per se, but called as Sahaja Samadhi because Samadhi is automatic and it is very easy to a Jnani who can see that his own Tattva, own Atma Swarupa is all-pervading. Everywhere, wherever the Indriyas go, there the Atma is. Not objectifiable. His own. He can reduce the object to a non-object where the underlying substratum is his own Swarupa. But there is, we have to take this with a pinch of salt. It is not literal. If you go to the Tippana, Jnanino Vishayopabhoga Kalepi Vishaye Dosha Darshana Rupa Vivekasya. When there is Vishayopabhoga, in the case of the Jnani, even then Vishaye Dosha Darshana Rupa Vivekasya. This Dosha Darshana in the Vishaya, which he has done over and over during his sadhana phase, it is automatic now. Even if there is Vishayichcha, this Vishayichcha, if it is not Sattvic, Sattvic Ichcha, then what will happen is that there is Dosha Darshana, which is automatic. Vishaya Mithyatva Nishche Purvaka Vairagyasya Vishaya Bhoganam Pariname Dukkha Paryavasayitva Avadharanasya Vishyanandasya Swarupananda Avyatiriktatva Nishchayasya Cha Jagarukatvat. So not only does he have Dosha Darshana in Vishaya, you know, there's Doshas in Vishayas. Atrupti Karatvam. So there are so many, it is addictive. First of all, Vishaya, because one thinks that the Ananda is in the Vishaya, it becomes addictive. It is not satisfying. It is not Nitya, Anityatvam. It wears the sense organs away. You know, it completely wears the sense organs. Even Nachiketa says that. Indriyanam Jarenti Tejaha. He says that whatever Yamaraja is offering, all the bhoga, all those are Vishaya bhogas. They will take away my indriya, strength of my indriyas, which I want to focus and I don't want them to run haywire. I want them to be controlled, not them to control me, but I want my antakkarana to be strong, my buddhi to be strong, my buddhi to have a say over the sense organs and the mind, and then tune it towards Atma. Not towards anatma, vishaya, bhogas. Thereby the jnani also, being that kind of a sadhaka earlier, vishaya dosha darshana rupa viveka is already there. Vishaya mithyatva nishchaya is there. Vishaya is mithya. There cannot be ananda in vishaya. And based on that, there is vairagya. It is viveka janya vairagya, not smashana vairagya, those kind of temporary vairagyas. There is a nitya vairagya. Vishaya Bhoganam Pariname, and when Vishaya Bhoga takes place, there is Antakkarana Parinama, Dukkha Paryasayitva, Avadharanasya. He has well concluded by Parikshaloka Nityadi that there is no Sukha which is Nitya, which is generated due to Vishaya. Thereby, once that goes away, it will bring a Sukhakara Vritti. Not by itself, but by the desire going away, what we saw in a couple of pathas last time. Then what remains is dukkha, because vishaya ichcha will come back again. That vritti, sukhakara vritti will not be there anymore because buddhi will not be achanchala. It will be chanchala again. Then there will be dukkha. Therefore, culmination is in dukkha. Any vishaya bhoga will culminate in dukkha. Even when the Vishaya Bhoga is going on, one knows that this Sukha will not stay. Therefore, at that moment itself, there is an underlying current of Dukkha. विषयानंदस्य स्वरूपानंद अव्यतिरिक्तत्व निश्चयस्य च जागरूकत्वात् एंड इज अलर्ट टू द फैक्ट दैट विषयानंद इज नॉट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम स्वरूपानंद देयरफॉर देयर इज नो पॉइंट इन क्रेविंग फॉर विषयानंद स्वरूपानुसंधान रूप समाधि सदृशत्वाच्च सिंहो मानवक इतिव ज्ञानिनो विषयोपभोगे समाधित्वोक्ति औपचारिकी. So the samadhi which is talked about, yatra yatra mano yati tatra tatra samadhaya, or even when he is indulging, he is in samadhi. All this is figurative. It is not literal samadhi. What is said is here, simho manavaka iti vat. What is the comparison there? In simho manavaka, you know, like the simha, this boy or this person is like a simha. So there is a comparison of courage, strength, all these are qualities which are compared. Similarly, there is a comparison between jnani interacting in the world and that being like samadhi. Because swarupanu sandhana rupa samadhi sadrushatvacha. Because he knows that this swarupananda itself is manifesting as vishayananda, when he interacts with the vishayananda, interacts with the vishaya which leads to ananda, he knows that it's swarupananda. Thereby, there is no additional effort needed for samadhi practice per se, which is the pursuit of ananda, atmananda, through chitta vritti nirodha. Here, this vishayananda itself is swarupananda for him. So, swarupanu sandhana rupa, anusandhana rupa, the swarupa, following the swarupa is ananda, in keeping with the swarupa. Therefore, that is equivalent to samadhi, comparable, similar to samadhi. Therefore, sadrushatvacha simho manavaka itivat. There is a comparison. The manavaka is not really simha. As though simha. So, simho manavaka iva. So, manavaka simha iva. That is how the simho manavaka phrase has to be understood. Itivat. Similarly, jnaninaha vishaya upabhoge. When there is upabhoga experience of vishaya, that time, samadhitto upti, that this is equivalent to samadhi, that is aupachariki, that is samadhi, not equivalent to samadhi, that is samadhi, that samadhittum of vishaya, jnaninaha vishaya bhoga api samadhi, that kind of an upti is aupachariki, it is figurative, it is secondary, gauna, not literally samadhi. Back to Mula. So, tatacha vishayopabhoge api jnanina samadhir eva siddhyati. It is figurative usage here. It is samadhir eva samadhi. Ajnyastu ayamananda swarupananda eveti naiva veda. Whereas in the case of ajnya, he does not know the vishayananda is same as swarupananda. Paramarthatastu jnani ajnani cha iti ubhayaropi. Swarupananda, swarupam ananda eva. Swarupam ananda eva. Ubhayorapi swarupam ananda eva. Swarupa of jnani and ajnani is not different. It is same atma swarupa, brahma swarupa. Therefore, ananda is the swarupa. Ajnyasya vishaye ananda pratitir bhrantir eva. Ajnyasya vishaye ananda pratiti. That there is ananda. He feels that there is ananda in the vishaya. That is bhranti. That is brahma. So, the answer given to Tattva Drishti is that Jnani also has Vishayananda. He also has Vishaya Pravritti. That is also due to Vishaya Iccha. The difference is that he is not hankering after Vishayananda when he interacts with the Vishaya. There is Iccha, but it is not due to Vishayananda because he knows that the Atmananda itself manifests as Vishayananda. This is the difference between Jnani and Ajnani. Dukkha Vishayaka Prashna Pratyuktayaha. So, Dukkha, which has been mentioned here, there the doubts are there related to that and those are answered here. Samsarika Dukkhasya Ashraya Prashnaha. If the Atma is Ananda Swarupa, where from is this Samsarika Dukkha? One is Atma Swarupa, but there is Pratiti of Sukha in Vishaya. Similarly, there is Pratiti of Dukkha also. If the Atmananda manifests as Vishyananda, where is the scope for dukkha anywhere? How come this dukkha? Sarvam dukkham. Buddha says sarvam dukkham. And it is very popular. Everyone says, you know, you don't know my sorrow. Everyone feels that the sorrow that that person is facing is the most. The grass is always greener on the other side. You feel that I have dukkha. Entire dukkha has, you know, come to me. Most of the people have this anubhava. So, samsarika dukkhasya ashraya prashna. What is the ashraya of the samsarika dukkha? He sadguru swamin as tattva drishti. From paramananda swarupasi. Iti bhavata yaduktam prak. What you have taught me initially itself, that you are searching for moksha, which is Ananda Swarupa, that itself is Brahma, that is Bhranti, because you yourself are Paramananda Swarupa. Iti bhavata yaduktam prak, tad aham samyak janami. That I have understood well. I know that I am Ananda Swarupa. The issue, however, is janana maranadi samsara rupa mahadukham kalatrayapi tvai nasti eva. You didn't stop by saying you are Paramananda Swarupa. Oh Guru, you told me that not only am I Ananda Swarupa, but the Dukkha that you have. What is the Dukkha? Janana Maranadi Samsara Rupa Mahadukkha. Kalatrayapi Tvai Nasti Eva. It is not there in you in any period of time. None of the three periods of time. Atastan nivrittaye tavaichha atyanta sangata iti. Therefore, dukkha nivritti, the pursuit of ananda with dukkha nivritti, that is asangata, that is not justifiable. You need not do that. Why would you search for ananda when you are already ananda swarupa? Okay, I understand that. But then dukkha is there, that dukkha should go. No, that is also asangata. That pursuit is ayukta, said the guru to him, because you do not have dukkha ever. But there is a dukkha pravritti, dukkha pratiti. Although the pravritti in each and every vishaya is to avoid dukkha and gain ananda, still the dukkha comes up. So there is a pratiti of dukkha, although I am not trying to get dukkha, I am trying to avoid dukkha, but still there is dukkha. In fact, it is not true that one is trying to avoid dukkha, because the means are different. If one compares what I want is my goal and means in sync. At each and every moment, everything that I do, is it tuned towards my goal, which is dukkha nivritti and ananda prapti rupa mokshaha, then one knows that the means are most of the time wrong. But this is what Bhagwan Sringeri Acharya says, Bhagwan Bharati Tirtha Mahaswamiji says, that the general populace, if you look at them, they want sukha. Shastra says sukha comes by punya, but they don't do any punya karya. Don't do Sandhya Vandana, don't do Nitya Naimittika Karma, but still expect Sukha to be there. How they want to earn that Sukha through Dhana. It won't stay. There is a lot of Dukkha, they do not want Dukkha. But they keep on continuing doing Papa Karya, which the Shastra says leads to Dukkha. There is a disconnect between the means and the goal. This is the reason that one continues in samsara, trying to force out dukkha using wrong means and trying to force in sukha using the wrong means again. But Tattva Drishti knows all that. Now he says that Ananda Swarupa, Atma, my Swarupa is Ananda, I understand. But the dukkha which is never there in me and my search for something to remove dukkha, that is asangatha, tava iccha atyanta asangatha iti atyanta. You know, completely in error. भवदुक्त इति भवदुक्त विषये तु कश्चन संशयो भवति. दिस स्टेटमेंट दैट द गुरु हैज मेड, आई हैव सम डाउट्स रिगार्डिंग, देर आर सम डाउट्स, कश्चन संशय होती थे. आई हैव वन डाउट इनिशियली सेज देर इज अ डाउट रिगार्डिंग दिस. यदि अनुभूयमानं इदं जनन मरणादि दुःखं मयि नास्ति तर्हि मदन्यं कमाश्रित्य तदवतिष्ठते इति दयया मे वद भोः. He says that since you already taught that the dukkha isn't in me, janana maranadi dukkha is not there in me, but anubhuyamanam idam, it is experienceable, it is experienced by me, this dukkha, janana marana dukkha, janana marana, and anything between janma and marana, all that is dukkha roopa, shadavikara. Not everything is leading to happiness. Most of the things are leading to dukkha. Therefore, madanyam kamashritya avatishtate. If I am not the source of dukkha because I am ananda sarupa and there is no janana marana in me, then I have this anubhava, anubhuya manam idam dukkham. This dukkha which I have anubhava of, it does not rest in me. I am Ananda Swarupa. Where does it rest? What is the ground for this dukkha? Kama shritya tadavatishtate iti dayaya me vada bhoho. So please explain this to me due to your compassion. Please help me understand this because the samshaya will keep me continuing in samsara. संसार दुःखस्य आश्रयांतरावगमे ही मयि तन्नास्ति इति मम दृढ़ा प्रतीति स्याद इति शिष्य पृच्छति. Why does he ask this question? What do I care? It is not in me. What do I care? What is the basis for this dukkha? Because even if he has heard, has listened to the guru saying that dukkha is not in you, because you are Ananda Swarupa, he agrees, I am Ananda Swarupa, but there is no dukkha in me. There is a doubt about it because samsara dukkha anubhava is there in him. It is not elsewhere. He has experience. Therefore, Tattva Drishti thinks that there is a disconnect between my being Ananda Swarupa, dukkha not being in me, but there being dukkha anubhava in me. How is that possible? There has to be some connection, some way there is transfer of dukkha from elsewhere into me, or there is some other basis which is different from me. Somehow it causes dukkha in me. So he wants to understand how this setup is. Samsara dukkhasya ashrayantara avagami, avagame sati. When the samsara dukkha basis of samsara dukkha is known, samsara dukkhasya ashrayantara, anya ashraya, which is the anya ashraya, anya from what? Anya from me, matta anna, anyaha, ashrayantara avagame hi, only then he is evakararthe, mayi tannasti iti mama drudha pratiti sya, iti shishya pruchyati, tattva drishti shishya asked. Only once he knows which is the Anya Ashraya, then he'll know that what he already knows, which has been taught by the Guru here, Shraddha, that the Dukkha is not there in me, but it is not Dhridha, because there is a Pratiti of Dukkha. Pratiti of Sukha is also there, but all that is in me. So, Mama Dhridha Pratiti Syat, what is that? Mai Tad Dukkhan Nasti means Tad Dukkham Nasti. Iti dhrida pratiti sthat, that understanding will be stronger if he understands as to where is this basis for dukkha. Na kasya api samsaro asti iti guru uttaram. Guru says this samsara dukkha, forget samsara dukkha, that is one part. Samsara is dukkha rupa, but even if you say sukha dukkha pratiti, rupa samsara is there, that samsara itself is not there. Kasyapi, nobody has it really. He shishya shrunume vachanam tenate sarva samshaya nivritti syat. Listen to me, listen to my teaching, says the guru. ड्यू टू विच ऑल संसार ऑल दी संशय निवृत्ति विल टेक प्लेस ऑल संशयास विल गो अवे जनन मरणादि संसार दुखम न कुत्रचित अपि अस्ति देर इज नो बेसिस फॉर जनन मरणादि संसार दुख एट ऑल इट डज नॉट रेस्ट एनी वेयर अनुभूयमानम अपि इदं दृश्यं जगत कालत्रयपि त्वयि मयि अन्यत्र वा कुत्रचिदपि अणुमात्रमपि नास्त्येव So the highest level of teaching, because he is an Uttamadhikari. Why do you look for this, the basis for Dukkha, which is not only Samsara Janya, Jagat, Samsara Jagat, the interaction with Jagat, which tells you that there is Dukkha in you, that kind of Samsara itself is not there, let alone Dukkha. So dukkha is samsara janya or the samsara eva dukkha. Samsara eva dukkham, but still that samsara itself is not there. Where will you have dukkha? So janana maranadi samsara dukkham na kutra chidapi asti. It is nowhere existent, that dukkha. Why? That anubhuya manam api idam drishyam jagat. Even if you have pratiti anubhava of this jagat, kalatrayapi twayi nasti. It is not there in you. Then the jagat is not there in you at all. So samsara dukkha cannot be in you. Mai api nasti. It is not there in me. Okay, it is not there in me because not there in tattva drishti as shishya because the guru has taught him. And guru definitely does not have dukkha because guru is teaching him that dukkha isn't there. What about others? Anyatrava kutra chiddapi. Anumatram api nasti eva. Elsewhere also it is not there. Even in Ajnani there is no samsara dukkha because samsara is not there in Ajnani also. Even for Ajnani really there is no samsara. There is a bhranti of samsara but samsaranam. But there is no real samsaranam for Atma because Atma is ekameva advitiya. Even if you take many that Atma is completely disconnected from the Sharira, there is no Sharira other than the Satta of the Atma providing it, the basis for existence also, Spuranam also, but it is not really there. Anyatrava kutrachidapi anumatravapi, not even a little samsara exists, the Jagat itself isn't there. Atayevasya Jagataha atyantanasha na kutrachidapi sambhavati iti. Therefore, this Jagat, now why Jagat has been said when Dukkha is inquired into, samsara eva dukkham is the karmadharaya interpretation by the guru. He says, you think that samsara dukkham, samsare dukkham, saptami, panchami, whatever you do, samsarena dukkham. But really, he says, samsara eva dukkham, karmadharaya tatpurusha. Instead of any of the tatpurusha interpretations, he says, samsara itself is dukkham. There is no dukkha due to samsara, from samsara, in samsara. It is samsara itself is dukkha rupa, and that samsara does not exist. Then where will dukkha be? Dukkha cannot exist because samsara, it is not there. Atayeva asya jagataha samsarasya dukkhasya, all in samanadikaranyam. Jagat equal to samsara, which is equal to dukkha. Tasya atyanta nashaha na kutrachidapi sambhavati. If you are looking for atyanta nasha of dukkha, which is the pursuit, moksha, pursuit is, earlier it has been said, atyanta dukkha nivritti. This atyanta dukkha nivritti means dukkha nasha. Adarshanam nasha adarshane. So there should be no samsara at all because the samsara is dukkha rupa, thereby one can avoid dukkha. This thinking is brahma. Although that is the very definition of moksha, pursuit of that kind of moksha is due to brahma because you are already free, you don't have dukkha at all because jagat janya dukkha that you think there, that jagat itself being dukkha, jagat itself isn't there. That jagat not being there, jagat cannot be dukkha rupa, it cannot be leading to dukkha also. So the nasha of jagat, which will bring about nasha of dukkha, दैट काइंड ऑफ नाश इटसेल्फ न कुत्रचिदपि संभवति इति इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल एंड ऑन दिस देयर इज अ टिप्पणा व्हाट इज अत्यंत नाश ऑफ जगत विच इज नॉट पॉसिबल यथा रज्जौ कल्पित सर्पस्य व्यावहारिक सत्तया दिस शुड बी उत्पन्न अत्यंत दिस शुड बी दिस अत्यंत इट इज नॉट पकार इट इज यकार सो यथा रज्जौ कल्पित सर्पस्य व्यावहारिक सत्तया अत्यंताभावो अस्ति व्हाट इज अत्यंताभाव नैयायिकास टॉक अबाउट फोर काइंड्स ऑफ अभाव प्राग अभाव प्रध्वंस अभाव अन्योन्य अभाव एंड अत्यंत अभाव एनीवे अत्यंत अभाव एज पर नैयायिका इज इटसेल्फ दे देमसेल्व्स क्वेश्चन अ पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ दैट बट जनरली व्हाट यू सी इज दैट बिफोर द घटा केम अप देयर इज प्राग अभाव ऑफ घटा आफ्टर द घटा इज डिस्ट्रॉयड देयर इज प्रध्वंस अभाव ऑफ घटा घटा घटत्वम नॉट बीइंग इन पटा एंड पटत्वम नॉट बीइंग इन घटा अन्योन्य अभाव सो घटा इज नॉट पटा पटा इज नॉट घटा फॉर सिंप्लिसिटी अ पॉट इज नॉट अ क्लॉथ इज नॉट अ पॉट सो म्यूचुअली द पॉट इज एब्सेंट इन घटा पॉट इज एब्सेंट इन अ क्लॉथ एंड क्लॉथ इज एब्सेंट इन अ पॉट सो अन्योन्य अभाव म्यूचुअली देयर इज एब्सेंस ऑफ ईच अदर इन ईच अदर रिस्पेक्टिवली What is Atyanta Abhava? Atyanta Abhava is complete absence. This complete absence. For that example given is Rajjau Kalpita Sarpasya. The Sarpa which is imagined in Rajju. Vyavaharika Sattaya Atyanta Abhavasti. Yatha. This Sarpa, when is that Sarpa there in Rajju? Is it there during the व्यावहारिक प्रतीति ऑल्सो इवन ड्यूरिंग दि प्रतीति ऑफ सर्प ड्यूरिंग दि अनुभव ऑफ सर्प कंपेरेबल टू दुख अनुभव इन जगत कंपेरेबल टू दि जगद अनुभव विच इज दुख रूप दैट सर्प कल्पित सर्पवत जगत तस्य सर्पस्य यथा अत्यंताभाव अस्ति There is atyanta abhava. It is not there at all, even during the pratiti anubhava of bhaya of sarpa, sarpa bhaya, even then that sarpa is non-existent in Rajju. It wasn't there earlier, it won't be there later, and it is not there in between also. As Bhagavan Gaudapada Acharya says in the Mandukya Karika. आद्यन्तौ च यन्नास्ति मध्ये अपि तत्तथा वर्तमाने अपि तत्तथा सो व्हाट इज नॉट देयर इन द बिगिनिंग एंड द एंड इट इज नॉट देयर एट ऑल इन द मिडल आल्सो इन बिटवीन आल्सो बिटवीन द बिगिनिंग एंड द एंड आल्सो इट इज देयर तथा ब्रह्मणि कल्पितस्य जगतः दिस जगत विच इज कल्पित इन ब्रह्मा व्हेन इज इट देयर इन ब्रह्मा इट इज नेवर देयर बिकॉज इट इज कल्पित Even during the Dukkhanubhava, Jagadanubhava, Samsaranubhava, in Brahma, in Atma, Brahmatma, Kalpita Jagat does not exist. What about the Jagat which is not Kalpita? There is no such Jagat. The Jagat is Kalpita. Not Swapna Jagat, Swapna Prapancha. The Jagrat Prapancha is also Kalpita. Brahmani Kalpita. तस्य कल्पितस्य जगतः ब्रह्मणि कल्पितस्य जगतः पारमार्थिक सत्तया अत्यंत अभाव अस्ति हियर व्यावहारिक सत्ता इन व्यावहारिक सत्ता कल्पित सर्प इज नॉट देयर बिकॉज द कल्पित सर्प सत्ता इज प्रातिभासिक सत्ता द प्रातिभासिक सर्प is non-existent in Vyavharika Satta Atyanta Abhava. It has Atyanta Abhava. It is not there in any three periods of time in Vyavahara. That Kalpita Sarpa is completely useless. In Vyavahara. Kalpita Sarpa, we want it to be useless. If you take a silver also, if you take शुक्ति रजता, दैट रजता इज कंप्लीटली यूजलेस बिकॉज इट इज कल्पित, इन व्यवहार इट इज यूजलेस, इन प्रातिभासिक सत्ता इट मे बी यूजफुल, वन मे यू नो स्टार्ट इमेजिनिंग सो मच ऑफ सिल्वर, नोबडी इज देयर, आई कैन गो एंड मेक यूज ऑफ इट, आई विल सेल इट ऑफ एंड यू नो वन स्टार्ट्स बिल्डिंग कैसल्स इन द एयर, दैट काइंड ऑफ अ प्रातिभासिक यूजेज मे बी देयर, बट देयर इज नो यूज इन व्यवहार. सिमिलरली in the exemplified in brahma kalpita jagat isn't there any point of time, paramarthika satta, as per the paramarthika satta, if you look from the paramarthika perspective, atyanta abhava of jagat is there, atma swarupa is paramarthika swarupa, it is paramartha, that atma brahmatma has no jagat and in any three periods of time. One cannot say that I am an individual jiva with the body mind sense complex and I do not have jagat. That would be foolish because the body mind sense complex is in vyavaharika dasha, vyavaharika satta it has. So continuing with the vyavaharika satta and claiming that I am free, I don't have any samsara, would be foolish because the reality, level of reality is different. It is a mithya statement in a mithya दशा, मिथ्या जगत संसार, बट पारमार्थिक सत्तया अत्यंत अभाव, देर इज अत्यंत अभाव, नेवर इज देर संसार इन आत्मा, बिकॉज आत्मा सत्ता इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम दी व्यावहारिक सत्ता, आत्मा डज नॉट बिलोंग टू दी व्यवहार वर्ल्ड एट ऑल, दी शरीर बिलोंग्स, द शरीर हैज एन इंटरेक्शन, शरीर दि सूक्ष्म शरीर हैज दुख प्रतीति, दुख वृत्ति इज ऑल्सो, बट देन इट इज नॉट इन आत्मा एट ऑल. नैयायिका से दैट इट इज इन आत्मा, बट उपनिषद सेज दैट इट इज नॉट इन आत्मा. तथा च पारमार्थिक सत्तया जगत अत्यंत अभाव एव तस्य नित्य निवृत्ति इत्युच्यते. एंड व्हाट इज दिस निवृत्ति ऑफ दिस दुख विच इज नेवर देर इन आत्मा, द जगत नेवर बीइंग इन आत्मा, दैट इज नित्य निवृत्ति. Never there is nitya nivritti, and what is that? That is paramarthika satya jagataha atyanta abhava. The prapancha samsara jagat not being there in atma by paramarthika drishti, through paramarthika drishti, the highest level of reality, the only reality, that is called as nitya nivritti of this jagat. So that is the tippana in the moola. The guru has said na kasya api samsara asti iti guru uttaram tata eva asya jagata atyanta nashana kutra chidapi sambhavati iti. How will there be nasha, possibility of nasha of jagat which is kalpita, which is never existent in atma at all in paramarthika drishti? असत संसार से कथम प्रतीतिरिति प्रश्नः. नाउ दि गुरु हैज सेड अत्यंत अभाव, इफ देयर इज अत्यंत अभाव ऑफ संसार, हाउ कैन देयर बी प्रतीति, दिस वुड बी लाइक शून्यवाद. सो दिस इज थिंकिंग, इनफैक्ट मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल से इफ इफ वेदांता मेक्स दिस दिस काइंड ऑफ अ स्टेटमेंट लाइक शंकराचार्य डिड एंड देन ही इज कॉल्ड एज प्रचंड बुद्ध बाय दि द्वैतिन्स, शून्यवादी इन हाइडिंग. He is not Shunyavadi in hiding. Even Gaudapadacharya at the end of the Karika, he says, Nache etat buddhena uktam. Buddha didn't say this. Those who think that this kind of Vedanta teaching, the highest level of Vedanta teaching is similar to Buddhism, they know neither Buddhism nor Vedanta. Because Buddhists do not agree that they are talking about Upanishad. They have similar conclusions. Vedanti does not say that we talk like Buddhists. This middleman who calls himself a Vedantin and thinks that this Drishti Srishti Vada or you know Atyanta Abhava of Prapancha, Prapancha not being there, is like Shunyavada, he is sadly mistaken. Or even Vijnana Vada, he is sadly mistaken because he does not know Buddhism, not qualified to make that statement at all. So these Dvaitins do not, who understand next to nothing of Upanishads, they making an aropa on Vedantin that you are prachanna buddha, that is like throwing mud at others without knowing anything. Very disheartening, you know, culturally very disheartening that द्वैतिन आर इन टू इंस्टेड ऑफ फॉलोइंग देयर ओन भक्ति दे आर मोर इंटरेस्टेड इन कॉलिंग अदर्स नेम्स यू सी इवन टिल टुडे द्वैतिन आर जस्ट स्पेंडिंग टाइम इन नॉट रिफ्यूटिंग इंटेलिजेंटली देर इज नो इंटेलिजेंस बिकॉज ऑल दैट दे हैव बीन ट्राइंग टू रिफ्यूट इन अद्वैत हैज ऑलरेडी बीन डन बाय श्रुति एंड भगवान भाष्यकार एंड फॉलोइंग हिम अदर टीकाकाराज एंड प्रकरण ग्रंथकाराज ऑल्सो बेस्ड ऑन द सेम थिंग विच वॉज सेड अर्लियर इनफैक्ट द्वैत एंड विशिष्ट अद्वैत इज रीपैकेजिंग ऑफ द बिट्स एंड पीसेस फ्रॉम अदर फिलोसॉफीज विच हैव बीन रिफ्यूटेड बाय भगवान भाष्यकार दे पुट टूगेदर समथिंग नैयायिकास सो द्वैतिन्स आर एक्चुअली प्रचन्न नैयायिकास नैयायिकास दे आर नैयायिकास इन हाइडिंग बिकॉज ऑल आरोप दे डू इज यूजिंग तर्क विच इज शुष्क तर्क विच इज बीन रिफ्यूटेड खंडन खंड खाद्य देन अद्वैत सिद्धि ऑल बृहस्थ प्रस्थान त्रय इज रिफ्यूटेशन ऑफ आरोप डन बाय अदर्स एंड सिंस दे डू वितंडा Bhagavan Harsha uses Vitanda to deal with these Vitanda Vadins. And he has a Vitanda Grantha itself called as Chitsuki. Chitsuki is a completely Vitanda Grantha by a Vedanti to refute these Dvaitins who have made Vitanda Vada. Vitanda Vada is what? Because you say it is wrong. That's all. I don't care what is said. Since you have said it is wrong and they use this many a time, Dvaitins use it. So Chitsuki Kara also uses their language. Ushtra Lagudana Nyaya. You take their stick and beat them up with their own stick because that's the only language they understand. Might as well spend some time in their own bhakti. If they do that may benefit because Advaita Vasana is due to Ishwaranugraha. They don't have Ishwaranugraha because there is no bhakti. They claim bhakti but they don't have bhakti. I'm not talking about everyone. I'm talking about those who make aropa on Vedanta, especially by calling names. They are not at the level of philosophy. They are calling names to the philosopher. That is the problem. Anyway, so asata samsara se katam pratiti riti prashna. But this is a valid question in Siddhanta also. We answer for a Siddhanti, not for those who make wild guesses and wild aropas. He krupalo sadguru janana maranadi samsara dukkham maiva anyatrava kutrachidapi nasyachit. If this kind of a Janana Maranadi Rupa Samsara, had it not been there anywhere, were it not to be there anywhere in me, in you, nowhere is it there. If you make that kind of a statement, Katham Tari Tat Pratyakshi Bhavati, but it is Pratyaksha Siddha to me. Even when you say that there is no Dukkha to you, there is no Jagat, I am seeing that. Even you who are making that statement are part of the Jagat. Although it is not Dukkha. Still, what you are telling me, the teaching itself is in samsara. How can the teaching be even without samsara? Even without Jagat being there? Nahi, nahi atyanta asad vastu kadachidapi upalabhyate. But you are saying it is atyanta asat in me. In Atma, in Brahma, Jagat is atyanta asat. But if it is so, then kadachidapi na upalabhyate. Upalabhyate tu, it wouldn't ever have pratiti also. Just because there is pratiti, you cannot say that atyanta asat. Jagat is atyanta asat. Vandhya putra gaganaravindadya asat vastu vat. Samsaropi atyanta san. Chet na kadachid api upalabhyate. Upalabhyate tu. I have experience of this Dukkha of the samsara, let alone dukkha. I have experience anubhava of samsara. Even now I am having that anubhava. If samsara were to be atyanta asat, I would not even have this anubhava. Like Vandhya Putra, a son of a barren woman is never born. How can a never born son be apparent? There won't be an interaction possible with a never born son. But there is this samsara anubhava, unlike the never born son. Gaganarvinda, you never see a lotus in the sky. because it is not existent. That kind of a lotus is not existent. Lotus in the sky. Unlike that, a samsara, there is samsara anubhava. Adi. Adi padena, shasha shrunga, or manushya shrunga, manava shrunga, all that. Asad vastu pratiti can never be there. The upalabhyate tu. Kadachidapi na upalabhyeta. Upalabhyate tu. There wouldn't be an experience, but there is an experience. Tasmat janana maranadi dukkharupa samsara nasti iti uktir na yujyate. Does not seem valid that janana maranadi dukkharupa samsara is never there. Iti shishya pruchyati. Therefore, he asks this to the guru. We look at the answer and stop. Samsara pratitir mithya iti guru ruttaram. That is why mithya. Mithya is taught. What is mithya? Sadasadbhyam anirvachaniya mithya. Cannot be categorically said as sat or asat. Really, what is it? It is asat. It is that which is asat, but they gives us pratiti of sat. That is the very definition of mithya. In fact, there are multiple definitions which does not have its own satta, has borrowed satta, that is mithya. Multiple definitions analyzed in Advaita Siddhi. But anyway, our focus is here. What is the Guru's Uttara? Samsara pratiti is mithya. The anubhava of samsara is mithya. Bhranti basically. There is no samsara, but you see samsara, that itself is mithya. Bhranti, janana maranadi pravaha rupam jagat. Janma, marana, then again janma, again marana, continuously janana and marana, that samsarana rupa, pravaha, it is a continuous flow, that kind of jagat. Gachati, gachati, gachati iti jagat. Jagat is what? That which keeps on changing. Continuously there is a pravaha, that is jagat. That kind of jagat, paramarthata kalatriyapi asad. Kalatrayapi asad. It is paramarthata kalatrayapi asad. It is never there in any of the three periods of time in reality. Even then, asadapi pratyagatma eva brahma iti ajanatam. But still, those who do not know that paramartha brahma is me, atma. Pratyagatma is brahma itself. Those who do not know, for them, ajanatam kevalam mithyabhutam avabhasate. It appears which is mithyabhuta. Falsely, there is an appearance. Tatha swapne anubhuyamana padarthaha. Yatha swapne anubhuyamana padartha. Just like the swapna padarthas which are not really there. Akashe nailyam, the blueness of the sky which is not really there. Rajyau sarpadayascha. In Rajju, seeing Sarpa, Danda, Ityadi, Jaladhara, Paramarsata, Kalatriyapi, Asanta, Api, Mithya, Evo, Bhasante. But still, there is a pratiti of Swapna Padartha as real. It is for a waker, one may laugh off, the nightmare was Mithya. But during the Swapna Avastha, it is real. It appears real. Although it isn't there at all. Blueness, there is an appearance of blueness, but there is no blueness in the sky. In Rajju, there is never a Sarpa, but there is a pratiti of Sarpa. So, there is no rule that Atyanta Abhava of Vastu cannot lead to a pratiti of that. Although generally we do say, Vandhyaputra does not appear, but still, there can be here Rajju Sarpa. Example is Rajju Sarpa. That's why a brilliant example. Sarpa in Rajju, was it ever there? It was never there. So, Atyanta Abhava of Sarpa still leads to a pratiti of Sarpa. Atyanta Abhava of Sarpa, not anywhere else. See, the difference is that Sarpa has Vyavaharika Satta. Not Rajju Sarpa. Sarpa has Vyavaharika Satta similar to Rajju, which has Vyavaharika Satta elsewhere. But in that scenario where there is Rajju and there is Sarpa Bhranti, that Pratibhasika Sarpa is never there in the Vyavaharika Rajju. Similarly, the Vyavaharika Jagat is never there in the Paramarthika Brahmatma. The realities are different. Kalatrayapi asantapi, even if they are not in any three periods of time, but when you switch the reality, they are there. Switch the level of reality, you are there. It is all appear, you know, appearing to be there. Mithyayo bhasante, tadvat jagat paramarthata asadapi, mithya rupena obhasate. So mithya rupena, there is pratiti, it is a bhranti, it is not really existent. And kalatrayapi asanta is what? We'll just look at this tippana. Arthehi artheya vidyamanepi samsrutirna nivartate jhayato vishayanasya swapne narthagamo yatha. So arthehi avidyamanepi samsrutihi na nivartate. The samsarana, the when artha padarthas avidyamanepi, even if this there is no real Jagat, Padartha of Jagat, really not existent. But still, Samsara does not cease to be. Why? There is a Pratiti of Samsara even if there is no real Samsara Padarthas. Because one is, there is a Samskara. There is a Purva Samskara. See, this is Drishti Drishti Vada. Dhyayato Vishayanasya. One who is having samskara and thereby thinking of vishayas, asya dhyayataha pumsaha, vishayan dhyayataha, swapne anartha gamaha yatha. There is no artha there, but still in swapna there is a pratiti of swapna padartha. Similarly, the samsara in waking continues to be, although there is no samsara padartha. Meaning there is no real samsara, but there is pratiti of samsara because of what? Jhayata vishayanasya. Because there is samskara which is due to avidya continuing, there will be a pratiti. As long as avidya is there will be pratiti. Then, iti Bhagavati. And in Bhagavatam, which is supposed to be one of the favorite granthas of Dvaitins, talks about Advaita, not only Advaita at a, you know, general level. For an Uttama Adhikari also, Drishti Srishti Vada, it is talking about samsara not being there, but there being a pratiti. This is Bhagavatam. These are very well ignored by Dvaitins. They focus only on a couple of bhakti verses, and that is their entire world. Because they never do an analysis of the entire thing. It is always pick something, that's it. Even in our statements, they'll pick only one part and try to refute that without understanding anything else, or you know wanting to negate but not understanding or ignoring on purpose. This is clearly seen in Bhagavatam. It is there. They ignore all this. Avidyamanopyavabhasate dvayo jhatur dhya swapna manoratho yatha tatkarma sankalpa vikalpam manaha budho nirundhyat abhayan tatasyat. So avidyamanah api avabhasate dvayaha dhyatuhu dhya. One who is doing dhyana. In his dhi, due to that dhi, dvaya, swapna manoratha yata, the swapna and manoratha, swapna dream and manoratha daydreaming, which is actually waking. Waking is, entire waking is daydreaming. Swapna is dream, but waking is daydreaming. For one who has this vasana, dvayaha swapna and manorathau avabhasate avidyamana api. Even if it is not there, the swapna and manoratha both appear to be. Tat karma sankalpa vikalpam manaha. Mana is what? Sankalpa vikalpatmakam manaha. Tattva bodha definition. So mind is always having options. Should I do this? Should I do that? Why? Because there is always raga dvesha, and thereby leading to karma. Tat karma sankalpa. Karmani sankalpa bhavati. Manasi sankalpa bhavati. Karmani. What kind of sankalpa and then vikalpa? Should I do this? Should I do that? Buddha nirundhyad abhayan tatasyat. And then when that goes away, when that mind itself, which is bringing about संकल्प विकल्प बुध निरुंध्याद अभयम ततस्यात देन इट विल लीड टू अभय सो द्वितीयाद वही भयम भवति व्हेन देयर इज द्वैत संसार देयर विल बी भया व्हेन इट गोज अवे देयर विल बी अभया दिस इज इन भागवत विल कंटिन्यू विद द नेक्स्ट 137 इन द नेक्स्ट पाठ सॉरी फॉर अ लॉन्गर क्लास वी हैव टेकन लॉट ऑफ ब्रेक सो आई ट्राई टू फिल अप इफ एंड व्हेन पॉसिबल सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपयो अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेरृक्यत्व निर्मलं अपारं सर्ववेदांत वित्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेव अहन्नमत्वान्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः तत्सत्
हरि ओम
नमस्ते
हरि ओम